Today, I'm going to show you how to zoom in Premiere Pro. Also, you will see how you can create different zoom effects on your footage. So when zooming into our footage, it all comes down to using the scale parameter here in your effects controls. So you can use the scale parameter to zoom in, zoom out your clip. You can also use your position parameter, your X value to move your clip left and right, and your Y value to move your clip up and down. And you can reset any of these parameters by hitting this arrow here and reset it back to the default values. Now, one of the easiest ways to zoom in on a clip is to use what they call a punch cut or cut to close up. And for this type of a zoom, you don't need any keyframing. I have a clip here in the timeline. I'm just going to move my playhead over. I'm going to make two cuts here on this clip. I hit C for the razor tool, make one cut right there, bring my playhead over, and this is where I want my punch cut to end. So I'll make another cut right here, hit my V key to go back to my selection tool, and then I'm going to select that middle clip. I'm going to adjust my scale parameter and zoom in, and I'm going to change my X and Y values to kind of center this. And so as I play this back, here is my zoom in or my punch cut. And now it's going to go back to the wide view. And that's the easiest way to zoom if you don't want to use any keyframing. So now with this clip here, we're going to zoom and we're going to use keyframes. To enable keyframing, come up to your effects controls. And if you're going to use position and scale together or one or the other, you would click on the stopwatch right here. And right away, it creates default keyframes. And if you move your playhead over, and let's say I want to scale this up. And when I made a change to the scale at the position of my playhead, it made another keyframe. And if I play this back, you can see it zoomed. And the distance between the initial keyframes and the last one is the amount of time it takes for your clip to zoom in. And if you need to move your keyframes at the same time, just highlight them and they both turn blue, and you can move them back and forth to change your starting position or your ending position or your keyframing. Now, to help with a smoother zoom, you can highlight, in this case, the first keyframes, and right click and come down here to temporal interpolation and say ease out. And you notice that your keyframes change shape. And I'm going to do this to my second keyframe and right click and say ease in. So what we're doing here is we're actually creating a bit of acceleration into the motion rather than to just abruptly starting and stopping. So this should make it a little bit smoother looking. Play that back. Next to position and scale, if you drop down this arrow, you see that your keyframes have a graphical representation. And so you can grab these handles and these will give you more control over your zoom. So if you want to zoom out, it's basically the reverse. So if I have my clip selected here and I'm going to click on scale and position to make my default keyframes, and I'm going to change the value of my scale here to something like about 150, and you just move your playhead over to where you want it to go back to your wide view. So at this point, I could either reset parameter, which is going to make it go back to 100, or I can put in the value 100 into my scale. I'm going to say reset. It created another keyframe there, and we're going to play it back so it is a close-up or zoomed in, and now we're going to zoom out. So that's the basics of using keyframes to zoom in and zoom out of your clip. So now another option for zooming in and a way to boost the scaling option is to come over to your effects and search for something called transform. And I'm going to get the transform effect and drop it on my clip. So it's the same as before. We're still going to use the scale and if we need to the position to zoom in, but this time we're going to use the scale underneath the transform effect. So I'm going to click on my stopwatch toggle animation for scale under transform. I have my initial keyframe. I'm going to bring my playhead over and change the value of my scale to something like that. And just play this back. But now what we're also going to do is come down here. We're going to uncheck use composition shutter angle. And then we're going to manually put in 180. And now what we're going to have is a little bit more realistic motion blur as if the camera is actually zooming in. So a little bit of motion blur there. So that's another little option to help you to zoom in. If you're getting value out of this so far, hit that like button and consider subscribing. So now we can look at something called a digital zoom, or a zoom that will call attention to a certain area on your screen. So a digital camera zoom effect is essentially when you're zooming in to an area in your screen from point A to point B. So for this, we're going to keyframe the position and the scale, but first we're going to set the anchor point. It's going to be easier to do this type of a zoom with the anchor point set first. In the program window up here, you see this blue circle. That's basically the center of the image in the video. And if you hover over it, you see this square box. So with your anchor point selected in the effects control, you can move this over to a point that you want to draw attention to in your video clip. So when you move this, it doesn't move the image in any way. The positions all stay the same for right now. And you can use this too on a subject. You can move that anchor point anywhere, like on somebody's nose or right on their eye, zoom in that way. And now we need to go under motion in the effects controls and click on the position stopwatch and the scale stopwatch. And I'm gonna move my playhead out. And this time I'm gonna change my position, bring up my scale and position it here. And there is my end of my keyframe. I'm going to play this back real quick. So I'm drawing attention to a spot on the video where I'm pointing out a control during a tutorial here, and you can highlight the last keyframes here and do an ease in. And this is the final really smooth digital zoom. So in this example, we're going to have a zoom, and it's going to zoom in the middle of two clips, and it's going to have some motion blur. So first we're going to come down here to the bottom of the project panel and click on this icon where it says new item and add adjustment layer. And so I'm making sure that it is the same as my sequence. And then I'm going to drag that adjustment layer over my clips. That's the way it looks. And put my playhead right in between the two clips. And I'm going to select that adjustment layer and go into my effects and search for transform effect. And I'm going to drop that on my adjustment layer. So now I'm going to make a couple of adjustments and come down here to my transform effect and scroll down and uncheck the use composition shutter angle. I'm going to change that shutter angle to 360. This is going to create our motion blur in the transition. Now without moving the playhead, I'm going to come over to scale and I'm going to change the value to 300. I'm going to use my left arrow key and move my playhead back 3 frames. And I'm going to change my scale to 100. And so that created another keyframe there. And I'm going to hit this arrow here that says go to next keyframe. That's the first keyframe, and then I'm going to use my right arrow key and move over 1 frame, and I'll click add remove keyframe. I have a new keyframe there, and then I'm going to use my right arrow key to go over 5 frames, and then here's where I'm going to change the scale back to 100. And if you want, you can change the position of these keyframes to change your timing. But here's the motion blur in our transition. If you want more tutorials like this, click or tap on one of the videos on the screen now. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.